Hi, I know it's strange to see me on the channel right now. First of all, welcome back to ThinkView. My name is William. I know it's been a while since we did not publish any videos because, to be honest, we wanted to focus on the domestic channel. However, during past time, we have always wanted to share technology content, not just inside the country, but outside the world too. So from now on, we will post more videos, so I hope you guys will support us. So today I'm gonna talk about which MacBook should you choose from the MacBook Air M1 to Pro 16. Not to waste your time, let's get started. Starting with the MacBook Air M1, on Apple page, it has the price of $1,000. But looking back on the market, it has dropped down to somewhere around $800. To be honest, this is quite a good deal to me because this is the cheapest new MacBook that you can buy nowadays. So the first thing I want you to notice before buying this MacBook is the design. By now it's somewhat outdated compared to the Air M2 or Pro 14 and 16. And with my personal perspective, the MacBook Air M1 no longer give me the inspiration to use like the newer version, especially when compared to some Windows laptop that cost somewhere around $600. They still have a better design than this. The next thing I want you to notice before buying this MacBook is the screen. Actually, you may think I'm wrong here because this screen is still extremely sharp, but however, I'm comparing it to the Pro 14 and Pro 16. They both have mini LED panels, very high brightness, very high contrast, very black and deep bold colors. And when going back to the MacBook Air screen, the difference is there, you know? Speaking of brightness, it will only be around 400 nits. You just need to go outside, you already start to feel the screen of the MacBook Air M1 will be a bit difficult to show the best colors. To be fair, we should not criticize the screen of the MacBook Air M1, or just because of that we choose the Pro 14 and Pro 16 instead. Here I just want you to know that if your needs are a Pro 14 and Pro 16 screen, then be assured that the screen is better. And if we continue to compare the Air M1 to both of them again, you can see the MacBook Air M1 is still congress at some point. For example, the speaker will only have 2 stereo speakers, and the Pro 14 and 16 inch will have 6 speakers. And they don't even support spatial audios. Even when you connect to the AirPods that support spatial audios, that feature is not activated. How about the webcam? This MacBook Air M1 webcam is also stopped at 720p, meanwhile the MacBook Air M2 and the later version already equipped with 1080p. But going back to the price, somewhere around $800 and $900, I must say this is still a worth buying device. Just remember that if your needs are a multitasking with quite heavy browser like Google Spreadsheet, Web Figma, or those who do professional work like programmers, editors, then remember this base version of the 8GB RAM will be exposed as disadvantage, and sometimes the device will freeze. As for the 16GB, the price has gone up for a whole new level. On Apple page, it has been extra charged for $200. It almost reached the level of the base version of the MacBook Air M2. Of course, the base version of the MacBook Air M2 that cost somewhere around $1,200 on Apple page, but it won't help you solve the problem of RAM congestion if you do intense multitasking. The CPU will only slightly better in terms of performance. The GPU-based version also has only 8 cores, 1 GPU core more than the base version of the Air M1, which is not that remarkable, and the overall performance will be slightly better. However, it has very different value in more stylish design. A thinner screen that is more inspiring you to interacting with, a high brightness, a better speaker, and a sharper webcam. It is even lighter and a bit thinner than the MacBook Air M1. So if you have money, you can choose the 16GB version of the MacBook Air M2 instead of the MacBook Air M1. The price is somewhere around $1,500. But if you want to do high multitasking and still save your money, then you can choose the 16GB version of the MacBook Air M1. But if you still want more, I can show you right away. To me, this is the most emotional MacBook that I have ever used. But let's not talk about its good point right now. There's something I want you to notice first. That if you buy the high configuration version, here I have both Pro 14 Max option and Pro 16 Max option. They both have the M2 Max chip, 38 core GPUs, and 96GB RAM. Then the performance of the Pro 14 will go shorter a quite clear distance compared to the Pro 16 version. That is quite understandable because the Pro 16 is built much larger, it's bigger, Those cooling fans are stronger, so it will keep the device at high performance better. However, if you go back to the version close to the base I have here, the M2 Pro with 19 GPU cores, then the performance is not different at all. And perhaps in this 14-inch MacBook, I only have a really small note, but basically, I still think this is a worthwhile device for most users. And if you don't need the performance of the Pro 14, you will still buy it because the screen is bigger, you will have more space to interact with. It also has a high contrast mini LED screen and the high brightness can stabilize at 1000 nits. So outdoor working is never gonna be a problem with you anymore. And hey, this is not the base version. The base version is the M2 Pro, which has 10 core of CPUs and 16 core of GPUs. I know the price is much different from the M2, but the value is much more different. Finally, the MacBook Pro 16 is for the creative needs. The Pro 16 is built much larger, it's bigger, it's bulkier, it's thicker, and you can feel the thickness in your hand. I think only those who do productions and really need a big screen, that is when the Pro 16 can show its value. So that's it. Hopefully throughout today's video, I hope you guys will know how to choose your MacBook that suits your needs. And if you have any question or concern, just comment below. Don't forget to like and subscribe for us. I'm William and I will see you in the next video. Goodbye.